Hey guys, Elvin Prince here, back with more Full Metal Alchemist Brotherhood. This is episode 17. Last time we found out that Hughes was killed way back in episode 10. And, what's her name? Lieutenant Reese or something? She is now being put on trial for the murder of Hughes, which makes sense because her body was one of the ones nearest when he was killed. Anyway, without any further ado, let's get into the video. And it's 1:30, I believe. Hey, Scar. Let's hope it's not stuttering.
This is the bullet that killed Brigadier General Hughes. It's a .45 caliber. The killer used only this one bullet. I'd say it was a good shot, but it was at point-blank range. Close enough that even a poor shot could have done it. Now tell me, what is the caliber of the gun that you carry?
It's a 45, sir.
Here we have a copy of your requisition form for additional ammunition. Does this look correct? It says here you fired exactly one shot. What was that round used for?
It lists the reason right there on the form. I fired my weapon in defense of Edward Elric while in the 5th Laboratory.
But the 5th Laboratory is no longer operational. It remains unmanned.
It was definitely not unmanned.
Sure, according to your account. Shall I send someone to search for this bullet you say you fired?
There was an unexplained explosion at the site. The 5th Laboratory is now a pile of rubble.
So the place where you claim to have used your gun was unmanned. And if we looked for the bullet, all that we would be able to find is a pile of rubble. Is that what you're saying?
Fucking
military. Lieutenant, we have eyewitness testimony. You were spotted leaving the scene on the day of the murder at the same time as the shooting.
That's impossible!
Calm down, Lieutenant. Fine, then. So what were you doing at that time?
I had the day off. I was at my parents' house visiting. Please, check with them. They'll tell you.
All you can offer us is your family's testimony. That is not admissible as an alibi.
Why is that not admissible?
Second Lieutenant Ross is being questioned. No one is permitted inside to see her.
I see.
Major Armstrong!
Sergeant Brosh.
I'm glad to see you here, Major.
Is this about Second Lieutenant Ross?
Yes, that's right, sir.
Oh, God.
Major, I can corroborate her story. Lieutenant Ross and I both fired a round from our weapons at the 5th Laboratory to defend the Elric brothers.
You did?
Yes, and it's all written in my report. But everyone's ignoring it, sir.
Are they trying to frame the second lieutenant for this?
They definitely are. Cold flame. Gonna have to be a bit more lively than that.
What are we gonna do?
Keep moving forward.
What do you think? What's with the face?
I'm just surprised. You've never asked for my advice before.
Oh.
I'm scared.
situation that could get you killed like Mr. Hughes. When I think about that, it terrifies me. I mean, you could die. I'd still be here, and you would just suddenly not be there anymore. Like my mom and dad.
This is life.
It's almost more than I can handle. Honestly, sometimes I wish you would just give this whole thing up. I do want you to get your bodies back. But I also want you to stay alive and safe. It's just... I don't know. Sorry. I'm not sure what I think you should do. I really don't know.
You're sure being nice, Winry.
Why you sound so surprised? I'm always nice.
Stop it.
Take that back.
You're doing the Elvis scratches. I'm already too dumb enough.
Music's nice as always in this show. Very fitting with the mood.
Your move.
Evening edition.
Oh, it's here. Excellent.
What? The newspaper? Again?
I'm stuck here babysitting you all day. This is the only entertainment I get.
Huh?
Lieutenant Fallman, calling on an outside line. Please connect me to Colonel Mustang. Yes, that's right. My code is...
What's got you so excited?
Iram, George, Oliver, 4649.
This is that lady from the laboratory.
Philosopher's Stone. People with the Ouroboros tattoos. The homunculi. How are they?
Oh, God.
Here. Don't scare me like that.
The newspaper, Ed. Read the front page.
What is it now? What?
Yep.
Second Lieutenant Maria Ross convicted of Brigadier General Hughes' murder?
I can't believe this.
Maybe the colonel or the major will know something about this.
What about Winry?
I'll explain it to her later.
I'm sure she'll enjoy that.
I'm not really a fan of these.
Quit your complaining. Every stray mutt needs a collar. All right, I'm gonna ask you one more time. Are you honestly 15 years old?
I sure am.
I don't buy it.
It's the truth, I swear.
Huh? What's that? What's happening?
We've got an intruder. Come on, give us a hand.
Oh, what? God.
Behave yourself. Got it?
I will.
Lame, lame, lame. Are you guys even trying? You can do better than that.
They're still coming at us.
The guns don't
oh,
even
God.
Hold it. Stay back.
Got it.
That's the reaction you're looking for. Are you gonna kill him?
It'd be a lot more fun if I was allowed to cut him out.
Nope.
Hello, strange armor ghost man. You think you could let me out of here?
Who are you?
Just an illegal immigrant from Shane.
Oh yeah? A foreigner? Well, have a nice trip home.
If you let me out of here, I can help you.
I don't have time to deal with you. Oh. Where did you say you were from?
Shing, east of the desert.
Come with me.
I'd be happy to.
Okay. Where's... What's going on?
What?
Best the military has to offer, huh?
Well, hello there, sweetheart. I've been looking for you.
You're from the Fifth Laboratory.
You haven't forgotten me. How sweet. I remember you too. I think of you every time I look at the hole you put in my right hand. Just like the hole you put in that guy Hughes.
No, it wasn't me.
Oh yeah? According to the newspapers, you're one guilty soldier girl.
I can't.
Oh well.
Oh, but
newspaper.
Right now it's looking like you'll be facing the firing squad for sure.
It's not true. They're wrong. If they would just do a proper investigation.
Here are your choices. Stay here and be killed for murder, or bust out of this joint with me. Which will it be?
How is this happening? Is there anything else I can do?
It sure doesn't look like it.
Or...
Let's go. If this is how it has to be, I'll escape with you. But you better know a way out of here, metal boy.
Ooh, you've got spunk.
Oh, God.
I'll do what I have to do.
Yes. Yes. Right away.
All right. They're pardoned.
Notify every zone in the city. Maria Ross has broken out. It appears she's with a violent accomplice. It must be caught. If she resists... order is shoot to kill.
Okay.
How much further?
We got, what's going on?
Just keep moving. Boom.
Lieutenant Ross! Edward, Alphonse, what are you two doing here?
You're the guy!
And Ling too?
Hey guys, what are you up to?
I could ask the same of you!
Quit sharing!
Good timing.
All right, sweetheart, take that back alley and run straight to the warehouse district. The darkness ought to hide you.
Wait, hold on. Tell us about Hughes.
Get going. If the MPs show up, they'll shoot you.
Lieutenant Ross!
Stay back.
No, wait!
Huh.
Lieutenant Ross!
Yep, and he's off into the darkness. Okay, Mustang.
You're Maria Ross, right?
Oh boy.
What was that?
Looks like they got her. Hold it! Get back here! Miss me! Let's go, foreigner!
And no. Now you're separated. Is that...
Right.
Oh, God.
What happened here? What happened here, Colonel? Tell me!
Full Metal Alchemist.
Oh, boy.
Full Metal Alchemist.
Mildly irritated, isn't he?
Was a fugitive. Our orders were shoot to kill.
So now you're a dog with the military.
That's all you have to say?
About Hughes' death. I apologize for hiding it. But you do not argue against orders or ask for explanations. Just follow them. That's what it means to be a soldier. Mustang, you will explain to me what happened here at once. The message went out that if she resisted, we were permitted to shoot to kill. She resisted, so I killed her.
Yeah,
I understand the Brigadier General was a friend. Yeah. He was a good man. Perhaps then it was one of your men who aided Lieutenant Ross's escape. One of my men? But why? Why, Colonel? I'll tell you why, so you can burn her to death with your own hand. think such speculation is best avoided.
Oh boy, someone's itching mad.
I'm truly sorry for not telling you about Brigadier General Hughes' death sooner.
It's my fault.
Don't be so hard on yourself. His murder wasn't your doing, Edward.
Is everyone here then?
Dr. Knox.
Oh boy. He looked like
body was almost completely destroyed. But judging from what little dental work remained, I was able to conclude that this is indeed Maria Ross. It's an awful thing you did, turning a beauty like her into a pile of charcoal. You must have held quite a grudge against her, didn't you, Colonel? Is the vengeance as sweet as you imagined it? The famous hero of the Ishvalan War going this far against a little girl. It makes me sick.
Colonel, please allow me to apologize for one of my own officer's actions. I could never have imagined that Second Lieutenant Ross would commit such a heinous murder. She was so straightforward and earnest, compassionate, a truly fine officer.
You can have anything for that, Mustang.
Fatigue seems to be getting the best of you, Major. Perhaps you should take some leave. Back east, where I was, it's a nice place. None of the big city noise. And lots of beautiful women.
After a daring escape, the fugitive is killed by Colonel Mustang, eager to avenge his best friend. And all's well that ends well.
Are you so sure about that? The plan was supposed to be designed to get Mustang to behave himself.
I took the bait. Now he doesn't have a reason to snoop around anymore.
Besides, are you sure about that?
We did manage to sow some animosity. His subordinates won't trust him much after this.
Claudia.
What's this?
Vacation
request. It's a request for leave.
At a time like this?
Is that a no?
No. It's fine. Request approved.
Thank you very much, sir.
Someone's angry.
What were you thinking going out on your own like that? Do you know what the Colonel would do to me if he found out?
Oh, pipe down, will ya? Nobody saw me.
Don't you get it? That isn't the point.
You're just a helpless soldier held captive by a big bad criminal. What were you supposed to do?
Huh?
Hey.
Oh boy.
What are you up to out there?
Building a signal fire.
Signal fire?
Bringing someone back here you know nothing about? How can you be so stupid?
Young Lord, we've been looking for you.
Wow, impressive response time.
Looks like a party.
Oh, God. Harry the Chopper.
Elizabeth, how are you?
It's great to hear from you, as usual. Are you sure your assistant won't give you grief for blowing off work to talk on the phone?
Nope, the coast is clear. She's out of the office at the moment. And a good thing, too, or else I wouldn't be able to talk to you.
Oh.
So how do you like that? He's whipped. The second the lieutenant goes on leave, he gets like this.
What did you think Lieutenant Hawkeye was?
Colonel Mustang's nanny or something.
Uh-huh, that's right. You know, I haven't had a day off since I got here, so I'm seriously considering taking some leave time soon.
Where are you going to go?
What is this?
I could use a nice, relaxing fishing trip. Care to come along?
Oh boy. It's lust, isn't it?
Yeah, who is it? What are you...
Oh god.
Major, what the hell did you do that for?
You listen to me, Edward Elric.
Oh boy.
This is no good at all. Your auto mail seems to be broken.
time to waste. Allow me to escort you to Risenbul for repairs.
Major, what's up?
What was that? You're going back home to Risenbul?
I have no idea what he's talking about, Al.
And you, Alphonse Elric, you would stand out too much, so you remain here in Central.
Okay.
Right. We need to make arrangements for transportation right away. Come along, Edward.
Oh, boy. Someone's...
Shut it out, Major. Put me down.
I'm afraid I can't do that. These are my orders. From him.
Okay, I got it.
From the...
Roger that.
From the top, or...
Elric have gotten aboard the train, sir.
Okay. Finally, everyone's out of the way.
Oh no, what are you gonna end up doing?
The breakout. Here, this is a rough sketch of the guy.
Oh, he's still alive then? Is there any direct connection to the Colonel?
Who knows? My money says he's the one behind it, though.
Where did he run off to?
Well, he did leave pretty suddenly. And he's good at hiding.
In other words, you have no idea. You're useless.
Don't blame this on me, you ugly hag. I'm short on manpower.
Manpower? But you've got plenty of manpower right here.
Oh, no.
It looks like you're finally on. Barry the Chopper.
Who's that? Oh, boy. Looks like we lost her. That sucks just because she was fun to have around, but Mustang's going off the deep end. It's only a matter of time before, you know, he just snaps and a shitstorm gets fired up. And Ling... No, we didn't see Scar this episode. That'll probably be next one, but... Yeah, Ling was being a... slightly idiotic genius. It's... not gonna lie, it was fun to see Barry the Chopper running about and, you know, doing all that. Surprisingly, a decent enough one controlled. Okay.
The truth lies in the ruins of Xerxes. The survivors who remain in the decayed, desolate city may hold the key to wiping away the darkness carried by one young man. Next time on Full Metal Alchemist Brotherhood. Episode 18, The Arrogant Palm of a Small Human. At long last, the counterattack will begin.
Good. Huh. Going. That's the seal we have from the beginning of the episodes, I believe. The series of circles and moon phases within the Pentagon. You know, it would honestly be really helpful if I could just learn what each of the different symbols within a transmutation circle, because from what I've gotten, the snake on the cross is the symbol of Flamel, who famously attempted to get the Philosopher's Stone. But yeah, that's... hopefully we get a more uplifting episode. As much as I love the moments of, you know, light, not light, you know, deeper tragedy that we've been, that we've been dealing with as of late, they need to be offset with a bit less serious of a tone. Anyway, if you like the video, please like, subscribe for more, check out the playlist in the description, and until next time, this is Elvin Prince, signing out.